Alright guys, welcome back to Let's Play Zwei The Ilvard Insurrection. Last time we left off, we explored a bit of the G Colosseum and we also found our way inside the Ordium Shrine. And in this episode, we are going to explore said shrine. We also met two adventurers last time, Pipiro and Poco, whom we are going to talk to later in this episode. And of course, it's a water shrine. It's flooded inside too. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. What do you think, Alvin? Wanna pass on this one? My magic is here, so whether or not I want to be here is basically irrelevant. Besides, it's not like anyone could drown in just this much water, I hope. Anyway, don't focus on such unimportant trivial matters. Alright, I get it. You don't need to be so high-strung about it, though. It's my job to keep you safe, ain't it? Yes, but I have no intention of becoming a liability. That would be beyond shameful. If I feel like I can't go on, I'll tell you, I promise. Alright then, off we go. Yeah. Alright, well, off we go, as Magna said. Let's see, there should be a rest stop around here. And since last time I went back and did some of the older dungeons, so I got a gold medal. And of course there are some unpassable sections over here. Down here as well. This one is another level 99 dungeon, which we won't be able to enter for a while. So the only way to move forward is this one. Once again, this area only has 3 dungeon sections, so it's not that long. First enemy, a flying jellyfish. It can shoot electricity at you and that's pretty much it. Most of the enemies you should probably kill with Alvin, in this dungeon at least. Since getting close to them with Ragna would be problematic, especially since most of them can release an electric current which can hit you. So just watch out for that if you are going for the Platinum Trophy. Oh, and they can also drop Swiss cheese, the jellyfish, so make sure to collect at least 10 of them. For the pizza that we promised that guy back at the farming village. And once again, you have to break all the pots, don't take any damage and make it in a certain amount of time. That was easy to get.
Finders keepers.
Oh, it is trapped by a lizard. Oh well. Not much of a guardian.
Kneel before me.
And there we got the pedometer. It's pretty useful, it just counts your steps, and that's about it. And here we have 2 angel statues, which we won't be able to do anything for with, and for the time being, soon. The way opened back, but it doesn't really matter. And here we have some spinning blade things. There are 4 of them in this area and you sadly have to go around and hit all the switches before you can proceed. So it's just a big time waster. Another arena. Oh well, shouldn't be too hard. Actually, let me use Quake Magic for now. And here is another new enemy, these fishes. As soon as you attack them, they start to charge at you. So just keep your distance.
All right.
More food items. Didn't Alvin say that this dungeon was at least 500 years old? Are we sure we want to eat that? And it's once again mini-boss time. It's just a bigger jellyfish, accompanied by a few smaller ones. And for some reason, it can change gravity. You figure that one out.
Kneel before me! Kneel before me! Kneel before me!
Hey, it dropped some eggs. Didn't know jellyfish laid eggs.
I deserve it.
I guess they do, but not chicken eggs at least. And we get the mysterious treasure. I'll be donating that to the museum sometime.
Not on yet.
Not even sure why I'm bothering with the pot, since I know that we won't be able to break all of them. For some reason I'm more lucky with those models in this dungeon than the previous one, not sure why. Guess RNG is just on my side. I at least got the cheese that I wanted.
Pretty smooth.
Yeah, I didn't get all the bases, nor did I get the no hit in. Phew, this is certainly rougher going than I thought. Good job so far. Why don't you go ahead and take a breather? Yes, I think I will. But as for you, what was that just now? Good job. You're treating like me like a child. Oopsie. Of course not. You say so. Once I regain my freezing magic, this annoying water will just be another slave to my whims. Haha! You hear that, stupid water? You won't be so scary then. Yeah, you tell that mean old water. Guess when you get that magic back, you'll finally be able to swim, right? Gonna take that as a no. And then how about I teach you later? You got the time. You can take it nice and slow. You'll be dog paddling before you know it. Can we stop talking about this? Me and swimming just don't mix. Well, let's just hope we don't have to do any swimming later on.
Time to take a breather.
I could head back to town and deliver the pizza, but let's just do this before that. To get another gear part in this area. Oh, great, now we have stingrays that can produce electricity. Of course we do. They are pretty durable though. And once you hit this switch, you should pick up the pace a bit, since that door won't be open for long. Just ignore the enemies for now.
I deserve this.
Ooh, a lollipop.
My turn.
With pleasure. Not done yet. Kneel before me.
Now this is annoying.
Kneel before me.
And yeah, these guys can shoot through the rock, so watch out for that.
This will be a blast.
And once again, once we hit this switch, another door opens for a short while.
Yeah, finders keepers.
Ow. Wait, did it actually hit me or just ignore me? I'm not sure. I don't see any heart damage, so maybe not. That would be a bit cheap though. Let's see what we got. A bit more defense, why not? Oh, we got this last time at the arena, but it decreases my magic for now, so I won't equip it. And the last door opens.
Hello, me.
Not even sure if that was worth the trouble. I did get a kiwi out of it. This area, another time waster. Great. Wouldn't the ancients build a bit more faster traps? No? Okay. Of course it just had to turn around. And of course it just came this way. For this one there is a vase in the back, so just be sure to break it. I'm not even sure what this thing is doing here. I mean, it chases you, but can't really catch up to you. Hope you like hearing Alvin say, kneel before me.
Kneel before me.
And another unpassable area. Just wonderful. There should be a switch around here. You can't always avoid a fight. Actually, you can avoid this one if you really want to. Just let me heal up. There are some switches that you can hit and open doors and get through, but I mean, this guy isn't that hard to just kill it and the door opens the same way. Of course, the bigger problem is his small goons. Okay, now it's just him left. And he's pretty easy with Alvin, I mean, he won't be able to hit me at all. Watch as he hits me. I think he is getting a bit faster, though not fast enough. And with that, the doors just open. Yeah, you don't have to bother with the puzzle. But I will just show one of the puzzle pieces. This one opens one of the doors and you have to hit another switch. That opens another door, and so on and so on. Any more enemies want to drop on me? No.
Going for the gold.
Guess I got all the pots.
Woo! Time to take a breather.
But more importantly, we get our second part, the all gear. Right. And of course, let's just quickly turn that in. Why not? And get a pizza while we are at it. Oh, okay, here's the pizza. For some reason it didn't show up in the menu up here. Guess I'm out of space. Oh well, as long as it's in my inventory, I'm fine with it. Oh, hey guys. Oh, hey there, Ragnar, Alvin. What up? Yo, looks like we meet again. Taking a little rest? Yep, I'm filling up on sweets while I'm at it. But it's totally okay, because Poco is picking up the bill. Oh, when did I... The friends that pay together stay together. What do you say, Alvin? Wanna kick up your feet for a little while too? I think I can get behind that. Besides, no time is bad time to overindulge in sugary confections. You got that right. Nothing beats a buttload of sweets when you're feeling down. You guys wanna pull up a chair with us, then? Don't know about you, but I've got plenty to talk about. And since you offered and all, who am I to say no? By the way, Ragnar, your weapon is an anchor gear, right? I've heard about them, but I'd never seen one in person until I met you. Makes sense. They are not that easy things to get the hang of, so you don't see them used much. Even by treasure hunters. Not that I see a lot of Katars around either. Where'd you pick up a weapon like that? I remember hearing that if you got good with a Katar, you can actually catch the spell monsters fling out. Is that true? Wow, so you know about that? I grew up in Arges. The guy who used to work as a treasure hunter lives there. He showed me how to fight with it. Hunter from Argus, eh? You wouldn't happen to be talking about Kites the Gale, would you? Whoa, that's the guy. So you actually met Kite before? Or really something else? Well, back when I was just starting out, he gave me a hand once or twice. Guy always seemed like a real live wire. Last thing I expected was to hear he settled down. What's he doing these days? Pretty great, really. He's living the good life with his wife and twin daughters. He's totally head over heels for his wife, too. The way he goes around about her is so mushy. You'd think they were still on their honeymoon. Just listening to them coo over each other gives me the heartburn. Wow, so quite the girl's a family man now. Well, guess I can't blame him. Treasure hunting ain't exactly the most stable work, even at the best of times. If he's enjoying the quiet life, hey, more power to him. Well, I can't deny that Puck's a nice, quiet place. Backwoods as hell, though. I always thought it was a nice place. Anyway, that weapon of yours is really something. You know, I always thought folks with those things around would be a lot more prone to fits and rage. And if they break, they've got to get special parts to fix them, so I could understand maybe frustration. But why would they make people rage? Because they are Angel Gears, of course. Get it? Did I just ignore him? It's what I do. He has a serious condition. Advanced dead joke it is. I'm afraid there's no cure. Ha! I get it! You leverage the fact that anger sounds similar to anchor. Oh, that's pretty clever. Alvin. I know, right? Finally, someone who appreciates my refined wit and humor. You're totally got a talent for wordplay. It's your responsibility to nurture and grow into the true master. You betcha. Hey Ragna, is that goth chick alright in the head? Well, I can see why you'd wonder. And that updated Poco's character note, and that's about it as far as I know. So let's return to the airstrip to turn in the part. Looks like you managed to rummage through another one of the Magistone gizmos. These look like they are from some kind of industrial equipment. Guessing for someone made them in a magic workshop. What for? I got no idea. Bet you I could make it work with that anchor gear of yours. Yeah, sure. I mean, why not? Alright, just keep your panties on. I'll be done in 3 shakes. And we get the claw gear, which is actually pretty handy for moving bigger objects and enemies while we are at it. If you happen to stumble across any more of them parts, just bring them on by. I see what I can do with them. Gotcha, will do, boss. Alright, that's just repeated dialogue, I guess. Alright, let's test this baby out. Remember some of those mushrooms and that one bait that we couldn't move and that angel statue? Well, let's put this thing to use. For the first one, we actually want to head to the end of the quarry. No. We did the outer tunnels, so the golem caverns, so the end of the caverns. And it's right over here, so the way you use it, you just hold down the attack button with Ragna. And he latches onto it and you can just move it out of the way. Find where you are staring, please. Not sure what that's about. Let's see, what else is here? Oh, hey. Whoa. We just have to take care of a few enemies by examining this thing. And once we do that enough, a treasure chest pops out and we can pick it up. That's about it for this area, so moving on. That giant mushroom. It should be at the end of the very... before the boss, which is... this one, I think. You do have to break these. Not beforehand, but to get past them, you have to break through them. Here it is. Just once again latch onto it and bring it to the end, basically. Alright, that took a while, but I finally made it.
It's my turn. Finders keepers.
And we just get another treasure. Let's see, next would be that angel statue back at the Ordium Shrine, so let's quickly take care of that. Although it's nothing special really. I'll just throw it off. Alright, I mended better the angel statues, so let's just put this thing to use. All you have to do is put it back onto its place. And it makes a pot appear. Yeah, that's about it, really. You need this to get a perfect mark for the dungeon, so if you're interested, go for it. But let's just quickly go back to Roata village and give that guy his pizza. You know, actually I think we do. Well, it's not like we need to chow down right now anyway. Here you go, go nuts. Alas, goodbye sweet food. It seems like such a waste. Thank you kindly. Was I just hearing things, Alvin, or did you mumble something about this being such a waste? Just a little slip of the tongue, hehe. Pretend you never heard of it. Besides, isn't it pinching your penny supposed to be a virtue? Just giving him one won't hurt nothing. It's always how it goes whenever food comes into the question. That was delish. I should give you something too. Share and share alike.
Looks like treasure!
Then we got the Solomon's ring. So, here you go. If you wear this, you might hear things that the way I do. The way he does? What's that? What's he talking about? Oh, and that also updated his character mode, so be sure to do that. And once we equip this ring, let's get rid of the... Oh, I actually have an accessory slot, so I don't really care. Once we equip the Solomon's ring, we can talk to the animals. Nothing really all too interesting, for now at least. But you can do that, you can also talk to the cows and the cats back in town. And that's about it. So yeah, let's just get back to the shrine. Alright, well, I made it back to the shrine and no one will interrupt us this time around, so let's just move on. Oh, and by the way, I don't think there is any reason to go back to the other standard anchor gear. Don't think it has any more attack or anything, really. Yeah, really, this one is just better for now. Oh, that pod just attacked me. So yeah, there are some mimic pods in this dungeon, so watch out for that. And yes, they do count toward breaking, so be sure to break them. And here we have some more new enemies. They are kinda annoying since they can make themselves invulnerable as they are chasing you. And here we have a giant enemy crab. I think he can shoot at you if I remember correctly, but I didn't give him a chance to, so... Oh well. Yep, he shoots bubbles at you. Oh yeah, I guess I can show off the grapple mechanic with enemies. You just pick him up like usually with rocks or such, and throw him. And now we have sliding mechanics, just what I wanted. So yeah, this ice is pretty slippery, so it will be a bit annoying later on. And of course it will be involved in the boss fight, because of course it will. And here we are, this floor, oh my god. Basically there are four fans in each corner of the floor and they are pushing you around on the ice. And of course enemies are involved. Ooh, a dorayaki. How much does that? Ooh, 49 EXP. I actually think that's a tier 1 item if I remember correctly. Sure is, so the more you turn in, the higher that gets. And no, you cannot blow up these fans, because of course you can't. And here we have a locked door, so we do have to find the switch amongst all this mess. Finders keepers. And there we get another widget, which is basically useless. It's if you look into a certain direction, it shows you if there is a treasure map or not, or a treasure chest, I mean. That's about all it does. It's not even that easy to use, really.
I'll handle this.
Phew, almost didn't make it. This is actually the place where the switch is located.
Coming through.
If you missed it, well, you would have to go through the area once again. Screw the enemies, even if it's a pot. I'll mess with that later. And here we have another new enemy. Let's just quickly grab him and toss him at the others, why not? He has a lot of HP, as you can see. Of course, throwing him against the wall won't do us much good, badly.
Get over here!
Was that a Mortal Kombat reference? You know what? Let's put the Earth Arcanum into use. I wished it would have done a little bit more damage, but I'll take it. Let's try out the other one, maybe that helps more. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Oh yeah.
And for some reason they thought they are going to hide the slot machine behind that. Wait. Not sure why, but okay. Wow, what roll, I mean. Putting it right at the end so you don't get the platinum, that's just... That's just plain mean. So yeah, watch out for that guy. I guess you have to get close to the door and back off right away. Like this.
A worthy effort. Yeah. Yeah. I suppose we should rest.
And beyond here is the boss area, but before that let's just quickly take out Odessa at the G Colosseum, shall we? Alright, I made my way back to the G Colosseum and I'm now level 6, so let's tackle one more rank. Yeah, Odessa, yeah, we won't be able to beat this guy in a while. I mean, you could try, but he can one-shot you. Yeah, the dialogue will be just repeated, so I won't bother to read it. This one will actually be a bit of a challenge, unlike Maurice. Where are the people cheering from?
Nice clean fight, okay?
Did it really look like I had nothing better to do? Well, you still came. Hey, you have a boomerang. The Wild West Cup.
Guess I'll have to be careful.
Just stay away from her and veil at her. For this one we actually get a pretty nice piece of accessory, so make sure you do this, especially for the next boss fight. She can charge at you, once she catches you she will throw you on the ground and it does a fair amount of damage. Other than that she throws her boomerang and that's all she does actually. You can actually trap her behind that bar on the lower right corner. I actually did it once. But she can come out of it.
Congratulations!
And we get the Salubrious Charm. And the model of Odessa. Oh, and if you want you to, you can get the model of Alven and Regna if you lose in the Colosseum. And you know what, let me just quickly do that. I'm just going to quickly lose twice.
Hey there.
Let's just show off what Galendo can do. Sadly we do have to sit through this. Well, you won't have to, but I do. Alright, let's get this over with. Good job.
If only you trained more.
Aww,
yeah, yeah, I lost. Whatever, I have to lose again.
Hey there.
know what? Let's give Maurice a win. Why not? This might take a while, though. Oh, he can heal himself.
Sorry. Help.
How unfortunate.
You mean I won?
Aw, too bad.
Does somebody said anything different to say now? Oh, he's not even here anymore. Beaten by the challenge of the Maurice Cup, eh? Miss Elvin, I'm not entirely sure you put up all your love and sweat and tears into your training. Oh well, what's done is done, but victory may be yours next time, if you bulk up with these protein pills. I do not want to bulk up. And that's about it for the G Colosseum for this chapter. Let's see what we got with the Odessa Cup. I don't really need the animal talisman yet. The Celebus Charm, which prevents poisoning. So that's pretty good, especially for the boss fight. Which we are going to do right now. And we are back to the boss room, well, just before it. And since a bit ago I actually went back to the museum, donated all my treasure, and I got an autonomous charm for reaching the Seeker rank, which prevents paralysis, but I'm going to keep the poison charm. I also leveled up to level 7 for the boss, since, well, I don't really want to have it take forever. It's going to be too long as it is.
Well, here we are. Looks like we've reached the end of the line. It's a beautiful old temple and all, but are you sure this is the right place?
Oh, I'm sure. There's no mistaking it. My magic's in here somewhere. The further in we've gone, the stronger I've felt its presence.
Really? That's a good sign, at least.
Yeah. But that said, I have to admit I'm a bit confused. I can't understand why I'm sensing it the most strongly here of all places. Wait, it's coming from underwater?
So you finally noticed, have you?
Who's there? Show yourself!
Clever. I can only assume we've walked carelessly into some sort of ambush.
Oh, rest assured, this is no trap. Think of it more as an exhibition, a chance for you to show me the measure of your skill.
Say what?
Just as I thought.
The hell is that thing?
The Lord of the Lake, Ephemeroga. And somewhere in its belly is the magic we've been looking for.
Good, good. Your senses are keen. Let us see if the rest of your instincts are as sharp. Show me what a noble true blood princess and her blood-bound warrior can do.
All right, well, looks like it's boss time. By the way, it's not the giant crab that was talking, it was a different character. This guy can do 3 basic attacks, 4 if you count summoning a minion. One is that poison, second is that smash attack, and the third is where he comes at you with his claws. And that's about it. For now, let's just keep him at bay with Alvin's magic, and sometimes dish out some damage with Ragna. And once he gets down, you can deal some more damage with Ragna. Yeah, that claw attack is kinda cheap since it's faster than you. Oh, and you can fall into the water. And here is the little fish that he can summon, but you can take care of it pretty easily. Once you get him down to 50% health, he will do some this, which is basically freeze the platform. And he won't really change up his attack pattern, but he will add one more skill to his arsenal, which I'm hoping he will show off soon. And let's just quickly take care of this fish. Don't bother using your ultimates, they don't work. And once he goes for a swim, he'll just want to stay in the middle of the platform and, well, avoid his attacks. And yeah, that's about it. Just jump around a bit. After that, I suggest just sticking to Alvin since, well, sliding around with Ragna close up close to him is not a good idea. By the way, platinuming bosses means no damage, first of all. Second of all, don't use items, and third, do it fast, so good luck with that with this guy. But he should be done after one more sequence of attacks, hopefully. Of course, I just have to run out of magic. Guess we'll have to wait for one more chance, since you can't attack him while he does this. I should have spammed magic while I was dodging around so that it replenishes sooner. That's one strategy you can use, I guess, but he's done all the same.
Okay?
Yes. I'll be all right. I'll just have to grin and bear it, as you might say.
Show your face, you son of a bitch! I'm done putting on a show for you.
The weakest whelps always bark the loudest.
What the?
A werewolf.
And so I am. Hear me, I am Dykor, son of the great Zeon, and a brave of the mighty werewolf clan. I see our dear princess is in good spirits.
You're one of the goons who stole my castle, aren't you? To think I'd see the day when a true blood would be hunted by a werewolf warrior. Does the old covenant mean nothing to your kind now?
It's true that we werewolves swore an alliance with the Truebloods in the war long ago. But that's ancient history now. As dead and buried as your father, who rose in revolt against the Gilded Demon Lord.
Why, you filthy!
But I have to say, I expected more from the daughter of the famous Duke Dekon. What's the matter? Can't put up a decent fight without your precious magic. But then, I suppose you are just a child. Without a thumb, without a fire in your belly,
What?
You're hardly what I'd call a worthy opponent. But let it not be said that I'm without a single shred of mercy. I've allowed you to recover your freezing magic as a token of our meeting. I suggest you keep training for when next we meet.
Owen?
Listen, Dogface. We heard you talking real big before, like you could wipe the floor with us. So how about you put your money where your mouth is? You want to fight? Come on! Here we are! Let's see if you've got any bite in them fangs.
An empty howl from a warrior as green and callow as his master.
What?
There!
Oh! Damn! Couldn't even see the bugger move!
Ragna! Are you okay? Look, I hate it as much as you do, but as things stand right now, he's way too strong for us.
You're certainly not lacking in spirit. I'll give you that. But spirit alone won't wrench a victory from the jaws of defeat. You should know how to choose your battle. I didn't come here to fight Princess Ulm, but to deliver a message to you. Your resistance, dear child, is amusing, but ultimately a vain and fleeting act. Accept your own helplessness, and watch in obedient silence as my grand design unfolds. That is the message my bloodlord wishes to relay to you.
What?
Maybe you should just sit quietly in the human village. The wheels will turn, with or without your medal. At any rate, I did what I came to do. I have no further reason to remain here.
At least we got what we came for, but we did get our asses handed to us. And there. I have to say, those alterations to our blood contract seems like they had more of an effect than I expected. You wouldn't have stuck with being my loyal vassal, you would have bounced back from a wound like this in no time. Yeah, I think I'd need to do more than just survive getting my ass kicked to take him down. So, Elvin, can you explain what he was talking about back there? Explain what? Come on, don't play dumb with me. I heard what the werewolf said. There's a message directed to you. Question is, who is it from? Honestly, I'm just as confused as you are. Can't even begin to guess who's left in the world who knows me, even know of me. Father and mother? Anyone else I could call family, long since passed on? For the past 100 years, I dwelled alone in the castle Mundria. Though, at least things got a bit more lively after Rue came to live with me. See? Ragna? Sorry, I didn't mean to pry. I guess you really don't know anything about who could have sent the message, though. Quiet, I do have one strong suspicion. Almost certain whoever stole my castle and my powers from me find this. And that they are a vampire too. Just any vampire either. True blood, just like me. Huh? Do you remember what the werewolf said? He mentioned his bloodlord. That's what you call your master after making a blood contract, becoming blood knight. For example, I would technically be your bloodlord. So that's it. How can you tell we're really dealing with the true blood here? They're pretty strong even for vampires, aren't they? Indeed, only those unblemished lineage can rightfully call themselves true bloods and wield the power that comes with that. This is getting more complicated than I'd hoped. First was that pesky cat, now we've got a werewolf to deal with. And given how powerful a blood knight is, whoever's pulling his strings is almost certainly a true blood. You got that right. That guy was all I could handle just by myself. So whoever he is, boss is, ain't gonna be no pushover, that's for sure. I'm afraid so. No way to know whether there are other true bloods still living in Granvale in these days, though. If my father were still here, he'd probably have some idea. And this sucks. But if we don't know, guess there's no point fretting about it. Anyway, let's get back to what we can do and figure out how we're gonna get the rest of your magic back. Well, and besides that, I need to brush up my brawling. He and I might both be blood knights, but he's in a whole another league, I could tell that. How uncharacteristic of you. Do I detect a sudden interest in being a blood knight? No, that's not it. I just didn't want to embarrass you any more than I already have. Just think of it as a man's stubborn pride. Just forget I said anything. You say so. You really are a strange one, Regne Valentine. What's that supposed to mean? I thought you'd react defensively when it came to preserving your own life. At first, I thought you'd be like all humans, after all, and you, why wouldn't you be? But evidently, you're a bit peculiar even for one of them. I'm not peculiar. I was just worried about you. Oh, look at you blushing. Oh, adorable! Wonder if this is what having a younger brother feels like. Don't say that. Forget this, I'm going to bed. Having to babysit a certain someone who'd sink like a rock if she fell into the water really fuckered me out, you know. You swore you'd never bring that up again. So they were at the lake. Todd, do you have any information on those two? I know little about the man. His name is Regne Valentine, a member of the Treasure Hunters Guild. He came to Ilvard just recently aboard his aeroplane. Or rather, he crash-landed just outside of Arte. The damage to the crash seems to be rather significant. Oh my. He crashed his plane? Sounds like he pulled the miles, huh? But I don't know. I think he'd at least have some bruises or a limp. Good point. Miles got really busted up in his crash and ended up being stuck in bed for a long time after all. He's rather curious, no? There was barely any sign of injury. The doctor Theo couldn't explain it. And there is one more thing. We've been completely unable to find any information whatsoever regarding this elven girl. Nothing at all. Not only is she not a resident of Arte or Roalta, can't even confirm whether she is a traveler. Correct me, lady. I checked the passengers' manifests at the airstrip and found no mention of her. But the day after Regna crashed, he appeared almost out of the blue, and the two began working together. Fiona? Do you really think she and Ragnar were the ones responsible for everything? And now I just can't say for sure. But there is no doubt that things have taken a turn for the worse since they arrived. Be cautious around them, you two. Huh? Did something happen? And to be honest, we haven't received any mail here for the past week. Shipment was scheduled to arrive 3 days ago, but it never came. What? They get mail once a week here? We only get mail delivered twice a year in Argus. Pipiro? I don't think that's the issue here. True as it is, indeed, not the only matter of concern that concerns me. It appears that even the radio signals have been completely blocked. Somehow, Ilvard has been cut off from the rest of the world right under our noses. Way. That's trouble to me. Is there any other ways we can try to get a message out? An attempt at long-distance telepathic transmission. If anyone from my family is nearby, they'll likely pick up on it. Telepathic transmission, huh? The offensive magic I can do, I'm great at burning things, but stuff like telepathy and psychic messages is a pain in the ass. It's not that you suck at it, you're just too lazy to try. Aren't you supposed to be a magician protégé? They even call you the reincarnation of the Holy Princess. Bah, Tiara is Tiara and I'm me. No people are still saying that about Pipiro, are they? But admittedly, I think we all feel far more secure if the Holy Princess and Knight were around at the time like this. Sorry. Looks like all you've got is a couple of kids instead. Don't be silly. You two have been a major boon for our efforts here. Truthfully, I had expected you to spend more time sightseeing. Oh, I would have, though I thought I could get away with it. But if little boy Blue here went off and died in some musty cavern somewhere, I'd probably feel a little guilty. So now I'm pinching in, and in return he's gonna be cooking all our dinners for the next 6 months. Wait a minute, when did I agree to that? Anyway, don't forget to exercise caution while you are searching for the jewel. And if there's anything you need, don't hesitate to call on us. So yeah, I guess that was Fiona, who we've met twice now. And of course, after beating a boss, we do have to talk to the NPCs once again to get their character notes. So I guess I'm going to have to off-screen talk to everyone to figure that out. Alright, time to get looking. Just to make sure I'm on the same page, we've got two of your magic powers back, right? Right, we can freeze magic. All we have left is my Whirlwind and Inferno spell, then I'll be back to my former strength. Oh, already half done, huh? At this rate, getting those last two should be no sweat. As much as I wish that were the true, I don't sense any traces of my remaining powers. Rue's been searching high and low, but I fear these last two won't be that easy to track down. What do we do then? Circumstances being what they are, I figure it couldn't hurt to pay Lyra a little visit. Fantastic idea, so who is Lyra? She's a witch who lives deep in the Glungel woods. Well, technically anyway. What do you mean by that? Back when my father was still alive, she served as his advisor. I've only met her a handful of times and I was just a child then. In the decade since she's been away from Ilvard as often as not, sometimes she'll be gone for a year at a time. If she's off on one of her tours or whatever, there ain't much point in checking. Maybe so, but there's also a chance she's here, and if she is, that'll make our efforts more than worth it. After all, she was Father's advisor, and he wouldn't consult with just anyone. He might have some valuable insight into who took over my castle. Ah, gotcha. I think I see where you're getting now. Well, it ain't like we have anything else to do, so we might as well go pay this witch a visit. Let's head for the Gloom Guild woods then. Agreed. We'll want to start from that village near the sunken shrine and head west from there. Once we've gotten everything taken care of, we should head there without delay. Right. Oh, hey there. Looks like we have a stalker. I knew those two weren't like the others. Alright, I made up my mind. I'm gonna follow them. We'll have to deal with that next time on Let's Play Zwei The Ilvard Insurrection. For now, thank you guys for tuning in. Until next time, have a good one.